Hello everyone, welcome to the NABARD Grade A 5-day question series, and as you know, I am going to discuss the most important third advance estimates of the production of major crops which have been released for 2018 and 19. So these are the third advance estimates, and this video is not going to be too long. Reason being, the data in this video is more of factual, and before starting with the video, please make sure that you make notes out of these numbers, because it's not easy to remember the numbers of all the food grains or the major food grains in fact. So it's important that you note these numbers side by side and remember and revise by the end of the video. So before starting with the video, as the exam is about to come, so we are providing the 10 marks of phase 1 and 5 marks of phase 2, that too for 999 rupees. So the gross amount is 1500 and you can use the coupon code MOCKS, that is M-O-C-K-S, and then can avail the discount and get it for 999 rupees. Now the first question is, which of the following is incorrect with respect to the third advance estimates of 2018 and 19. So I have tried, or I'll be telling you about the types of question which could be framed out of these third advance estimates apart from the factual question. So this first question could be the possible question. So the Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare released these estimates. Now it's important to note that the Department of Agriculture, it comes under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, and they have collected this data, or that it has been received or collected or retrieved from the feedback which has been provided from the state governments. So Department of Agriculture has combined and released this data for the third advance estimates. Next is, the food grains production is estimated 283.37 million tons. Now this is absolutely correct, as the food grains production, now this is important, you need to remember this number, 283.37 million tons is the estimated food production or food grains production for 2018 and 19 according to this third advance estimate. The next statement is, wheat was the major contributor, and the last statement is, rice was the major contributor. So for that we need to look at the contribution or the production of the wheat and rice for the 2018 and 19. So as per these estimates, the food grains, as I have told you, they are estimated at 283.37 million tons, and rice have a record production of 115.63, and wheat has a record production of 101.2. Now as you can see among these, that rice is the major contributor among the food grains. So what possibly could be the next question? So which of the following food grains is the maximum contributor in the food grain productions for 2018-19 as per the third advance estimate? So here you can note that rice is the major contributor by having a production of 115.63 million tons. Now, as it is a record production, so it's important to remember these two numbers as well. So for this statement, the wheat was not the major contributor. So this is the incorrect statement for this question. The C is the incorrect statement, that wheat was not the major contributor among the estimated food grains, but rice was the major contributor among the estimated food grains. Moving on to the next one, so as per the third advance estimates, what is the estimated production of oilseeds during 2018-19? So the oilseeds production is estimated to be 31.42 million tons. So 31.42 million tons, where soya bean is the major contributor. So what could be the possible question out of it, out of this, that which crop was the major contributor among the oil seeds in the, as per the third advance estimate? So soybean has contributed or is expected to contribute 13.74 million tons among these 31.42 million tons of oil seeds. Similarly, rapeseeds and mustard, they have estimated production of 8.78 million tons. I hope you are making notes out of it, or you can just pause the video and take screenshot of this table and try to remember them. The next question is, as per the third advance estimate, the similar estimate, the increase in the food grains than the previous 5 years. So we need to tell the increase as per the average. So as you know that it is, the food grains have been estimated to be 283.37 million tons. So the estimated increase is 17.62 million tons than the previous 5 years average. So the average production for the food grains was 265.75 million tons. So this was the average production. Adding on the 17.62 million tons, the current production or the estimated production for 2018 comes out to be 283.37 million tons. The next question is, what is the estimated record production of sugarcane? Now, here the question is just regarding the sugarcane, but it can come for rice, wheat, cotton, soybean. Reason being, they are being counted among the major contributors. So therefore, the question might come from for these rice, wheat, cotton or soybean as well. For cotton, it is 27.59 and for sugarcane, it's 400.37. So the answer of this question is 400.37 million tons is the total production of sugarcane. And this is approximately 20.46 million tons increase from the 2017-18 production. So by adding the 20.46 million tons of sugar cane, we are now producing or estimated to produce 400.37 million tons in 2018-19, which is an increase of 20.46 million tons over 2017-18 total production. The next question is, and be careful about this question, there's a difference between the horticulture estimates and the food crops estimates. The question here is asking about the production of fruits as per the 2017-18 final estimates. The production of fruits is different from the total horticulture production. The total horticulture production as per the final estimates was 311.71 million tons, and for the fruits it stands at 97.35 million tons. Similarly, for the vegetables, the production is estimated to be 187.5 million tons. So the fruits and vegetables are contributing over 284 million tons of production to the horticulture crops. So what's important in this question, the total estimates for 2017-18 and the first advance estimates of 2018-19. And remember, the first advance estimates have been released for horticulture crops. The third advance estimates have been released for the food crops. Now it's time for you to comment the deficiency of dash. So you need to tell me the deficiency of which mineral or elements causes the whiptail disorder in cauliflower. So mention your answers. It's quite a difficult question as compared to the previous one I've asked. So you need to answer in the comment section that the deficiency of dash causes whiptail disorder in cauliflower. It's important that you know about the diseases, the physiological disorders in the fruits and vegetables and the crops. I hope you're preparing well for the examination. Do not forget to subscribe to our channel Anuj Jindal. Also press the bell icon, which is just next to the subscribe button. Reason being, you will be getting the notifications as and when the video is being posted. Also stay tuned for the next video. Thank you so much for watching the video.